Please excuse the creased t-shirt, I don't tend to do ironing on my day off. And it's my day off today, and on my day off, I like to do videos! Hi guys, it's Alex Romano. How's everyone doing? Good, 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 I hope. Kind of recently-ish, I did a 10 powdery designer fragrances video, so I wanted to do 10 powdery niche ones because I collect both designer and niche fragrances, so why not? Powdery nuances can come from lots of different things. Mainly it's florals from my experience, things like roses, violets, iris, heliotrope, stuff like that. But there are certain things like sandalwood as well where you can get a powdery nuance. Or sometimes there's just an entire fantasy feeling where it's like baby bum, baby powder type thing. Johnson's baby powder. Anyway, I did my 10 designers, so I want to do my 10 niche. This isn't a 10 favourites, it's just 10 powdery fragrances that I think are worth visiting if you want to add a few powderies to your collection. So let's begin. The first one on my list is probably my favourite. Normally it's a countdown, but this is just a 10 powdery fragrances video. It's this one. It's called Nightingale and it is by Zoologist. I make no bones about the fact that this perfume house is one of my favourites. Probably my favourite, but definitely up there with my favourites. I'm always excited about their releases. And this is in my top three from the entire line of 13 fragrances that come from Zoologist. Look at it. It's pink. And this fragrance is centered around rose, plum blossom, and violet, so it's very vintage powdery feeling. Roses and violets mainly are powdery, but roses can be, as well as being jammy sometimes, or even metallic. And this one is lovely. It's super strong powdery fragrance. It's massive. It's a real heavy hitter in terms of something that's quite soft. I like it when a powdery fragrance is powerful, and this one fits the bill. You've also got some resins in there, you've got frankincense and myrrh, there's also oud in it. It's essentially a chypre, so when it does dry it becomes a lot more woody, not as powdery, but man, this is one crazy powdery fragrance, and it's almost psychedelically pink, which I really, really like. I think that's fun. This is probably my favourite, so I wanted to start with this one. It's Nightingale by Zoologist. The next one on the list is called Citizen Queen and it's by Juliet Has a Gun. I fell in love with this the minute I smelled it. It's one of those fragrances that I couldn't really get out of my head too much. It was kind of haunting me a little bit, and it is up there with one of my most favourite powdery fragrances I've ever smelled. Heaven! This one's centred around iris, or orris root as it's more commonly known. Just a little tip. Iris is not a flower that can be distilled or put into fragrance. It's always the root of the flower, which creates this gorgeous makeup-y, soft, warm feeling. This is about iris and a really, really soft leather, which sounds like it might not go together, but it really does, because it's almost like a suede-y type, suede, powdery iris thing. It's really stunning. I wore this to bed last night, actually, funnily enough, which kind of is what prompted me to do this video. But yeah, this is my favourite from Juliet Has a Gun line. They tend to favour roses. That's kind of their signature. They have a lot of fragrances that centre around rose. So this is why this one kind of stuck out a little bit. And when I smelled it, I was instantly in love. And the bottle is really cool as well. You can just do your hair in it while you're spraying it on. You can be like, yeah, you know. The next one is Lyric Woman by Amouage. This is, I think, the first ever Amouage I got. Maybe not, I don't know. But this is another rose fragrance. Like I said, roses often give a powdery nuance to a fragrance. And this one is probably one of the more exquisite fragrances that I own. It just feels very special when you wear it. There's a kind of waxy, resinous feel to the rose in this one, but the powder element is something that just feels very expensive to me. And that's a weird thing to say, because what smells expensive? Who knows? It's different for everyone, but you can just feel that it's very well made. It's almost like a fruity, waxy, powdery rose, and it's a tough one to describe, but I have reviewed it, I have also reviewed Nightingale, and I've also reviewed Citizen Queen, if you care to go and check them out. I can't speak today. I have these days. It's my day off, I'm excited, okay? The next one is one that I don't own, but I'm very familiar with. It's called Il Anguara, and it's by Faden. It's Pierre Guillaume, he's the guy that owns or is behind Parfumerie Generale. It's a really beautiful almond and ylang ylang fragrance. It's really simple, it doesn't have the most complicated note list in the world, and it does step into the more gourmand territory because the almond makes it feel almost edible. But the ylang ylang and almond create this really beautiful, soft, powdery feeling that's really wearable and really cozy and really friendly and really easy to like. It's a lovely fragrance, and if you don't like stuff that is too in your face or too complex, if you like things to be a little bit more subtle and stripped back, maybe try this one, Il Anguara by Faden. The next one is another one that I don't actually own, but I've had samples of it and I really like it. It's Volutes by Diptyque. This one on paper to me was kind of strange in my head. I read the notes and I thought tobacco and iris and all of this kind of stuff. I didn't think it would match, but man, is it a gorgeous fragrance. Iris or orris and tobacco really work hand in hand in this fragrance. So it's powdery from iris, but it's got a bit of a whack and a bit of depth, and just tobacco is such a stunning note in fragrances anyway. Obviously not for everyone, but I personally find it really, really pleasant and lovely to wear. So it's almost like a very rich iris. It's backed up by this lovely tobacco leaf element, and it's really pretty and a little bit unusual, but it's nice to have a powdery fragrance that has a bit of oomph, kind of like Nightingale. It's a good one, try it out. The next one is one by Parfumerie Generale. It's called Bouquet Massai. It was a rework of his, it's called 10.1 Bouquet Massai. It was a rework of his number 10, which I can't remember what that is right now, actually. Oh, Eau Massai. Eau Massai was an overly caramelised, spicy fragrance, where Bouquet Massai, and coffee as well, Bouquet Massai is centred around peony, and with an underlying tone of coffee. It's a powdery fragrance that has a massive effervescence. It's kind of sparkly. It kind of twinkles on your skin when you wear it. It's a very, very pretty fragrance. It's lovely. Peony to me is always kind of related to rose a little bit, so that's where the element of powdery comes in. It's a lovely one. It's really easy to wear, and it's a gorgeous niche fragrance that when I go to work sometimes, I just lavish myself with it. It's powdery in a bright kind of way. It's lovely. The next one is one I have on my arm because I have a sample, and it's Lipstick Rose by Frederick Malle. A lot of these ones have roses in them because, like I said, rose is responsible for powder. I don't want to sound like a broken record, but this one is called Lipstick Rose because it, again, features iris, I think. It's not listed in the notes that I know of, or maybe it is. I'm going on the way it smells. I've never really looked at the note list, but this is more jammy though. The rose in this one is really pronounced. It's got a lot of body and it's kind of almost like a syrupy jammy rose, but the background of this fragrance is very powdery and it's strong. I've got a few things on my arms today and this is the one that keeps wafting up at me over everything. So again, that's why it's on the list. I like things that are powdery but have punch, not like a veil. This next one is one that every time, I keep forgetting about it actually all the time, and every time I smell it, I fall just that little bit more in love with it, and I don't really hear it talked about very much. It's Lalibela by Memo Paris. I'm sure it's Memo Paris. And now that I think about it, I've not smelled a bad fragrance by them. I've smelled 4 of their line, and all of them to me have struck me as being something really, really good. Lalibela is here. It's really, really beautiful. I think it's probably, apart from Nightingale, this could take over a few of my favourite powdery fragrances in my collection. It's kind of like a tropical powder. There's coconut in here. A soft coconut powdery fragrance that isn't that typical sunscreen boring kind of thing. It's really refined, it's really gorgeous, and looking at the notes, I would never think that it would be powdery. It has tobacco in it, it has frankincense in it, it has labdanum in it, so looking at it, you would think that it would be more of like an oriental resinous type thing, but in reality, it is quite powdery, but it's a real stunning, stunning powdery fragrance. Wow, just try this one out. I can't say much more about it than that, because I've only worn it a few times, and every time, I swoon. Lalibela. So the second to last one on the list is also by Pierre Guillaume. It's part of his Black collection, which used to be called UTM Art, but it isn't anymore. It's called Poudre de Riz. It's in the title. It's like rice powder. This is another iris fragrance. It's rice. It's got that almost starchy makeup one kind of feeling. This one is ultra soft. It's one of those ones that is kind of like a veil. It's instantly likeable if you're a fan of powdery things. There's enough bite in it. You can really feel the kind of butteriness of the orris in it. But it's so fluffy, this one. It's almost like a sheer kind of woolen type fuzzy jumper type smell. Really good one. I don't want to say too much about that one because I've only worn it a few times, but it sticks out as an amazing powdery fragrance from the niche world. Poudre de Riz. Poudre de Riz by Pierre Guillaume. And the last one on the list is quite an obscure one. It's by a lady called Naomi Goodsir. She isn't actually the perfumer, she is the curator. She only has 5 fragrances, which I have smelled all of them. And all of them are very special in their own way. Kir Velour is centered around a kind of, I guess you could call it a suede-y type feeling. So it is essentially a leathery type fragrance, but it feels so like suede-y, suede powdery, like suede cushions. It's got a lot of immortelle in it, and also it's got tobacco in it as well. I can't speak today. It's also got tobacco in there as well. It's like a very subtle powdery leather type thing. It's really rich, but subtle. It's when you smell it, it's got a lot of body to it, but there is a subtlety to it that makes it really exquisite. I really like it. And Immortelle usually I don't like because it sometimes smells like curry, but she's slotted it in really well in this one. It lasts a really long time, it's really high quality, and I love it. And it's by no means least because it's last. It's just a different take on a powdery, a suede-y, leathery type powder fragrance. Anyway, I think I've spoken enough. So I hope you guys like this video. I'm Arch110, click my logo down there to subscribe. And I hope you made some nice new powdery discoveries. Let me know what you think if you try any of them or have tried any of them. Okay, goodbye.